evening, everyone.
Good evening.
On behalf of my colleague, Rabbi Osachi, and myself, I would like to welcome you to Beth Tzedek congregation for this hopefully wonderful and meaningful evening, a celebration of Jewish choral music. We have the great honor this evening to host in this sanctuary three top-notch choirs. Two from Calgary, the Calgary Renaissance Singers and Players, who specialize in music of the Renaissance, the Spiritus Chamber Choir, and all the way from Los Angeles, the Los Angeles Zimria Choral. They are going to be entertaining you this evening and hopefully enlightening you with the depth and breadth of what Jewish choral works are. You're going to hear works this evening all the way from the Renaissance and Salomone Rosse right up to the 21st century and Canada's own Choral Irving Gluck. And it is a great honor to bring these three choirs and to have such talent represented here this evening in this sanctuary. We would not be able to put on a program of this caliber if it wasn't for the generous support of donors that are members of this congregation. And before we begin, I would like to publicly acknowledge those members of this congregation that donated generously toward funding this event. James Kaskinet and Betty Sherwood, Stuart Bondar and Alex Kaganoff, Stephen Iskovich, Brian Sanders, Harvey and Wynn Thal, Sam and Cindy Feldman, David and Susan Inhamer, Steve Kaganoff, Eric Kettner, Phil and Harriet Libin, Terry and Kim Libin, Mark and Debbie Staniloff, Bill and Lily Lister, Lauren Tucker and Bev Sklar, Darren and Marnie Bondar, Sam and Lauren Bell, and Lauren Pearl. And I would like you to introduce further ado, we will commence the program, and I would like to welcome to the stage at this time the Calgary Renaissance Singers and Players.
Putting on this concert for all of us this evening. Thank you so much for being here with us.
Of course, we have Spiritus Chamber Choir with us this evening, Calgary's own, and all the way from Los Angeles, Los Angeles Zimbion Choral, wonderful partners to have with us on stage. And once again, Cantor Russell has already said this, but on behalf of my choir, I would like to reiterate the thanks to all the generous donors from this congregation who helped to make this evening's concert possible. Thank you so much. We opened our program this evening with a piece by the late Toronto composer Cyril Irving Glick. Mr. Glick passed away in 2002. He's one of Canada's best-known choral composers for choral works written in Hebrew. We're just delighted to be able to sing this piece for you this evening. The text, of course, comes from Psalm 150, "Praise the Lord with the sound of trumpets, the sound of flutes, the sound of cymbals." We now move on to a piece by the Jewish-Italian Renaissance composer Salomone Rossi. Mr. Rossi was born sometime around the year 1570 and died in 1630. Mr. Rossi was known for several firsts, which included creating the form that became known as the trio sonata, something that Haydn and Mozart and others went on to enjoy and give us great music for the world. Mr. Rossi wrote this setting of Elohim Hashivenu, "Turn us back to you and we shall return."
Thank you.
This next piece was written by a cantor who worked in the late 1800s, early 1900s for the oldest Jewish congregation in Canada. This was the Spanish and Portuguese synagogue in Montreal. That congregation is celebrating its 250th anniversary this year. This piece was written by their cantor Meldola de Sola to help to consecrate a brand new synagogue to which the congregation moved in 1891. Part of our concert production team for this very special event this evening has included cantor Russell Jane, the cantor here at Bethsaida Conservative Congregation. And I can't tell you how delighted we are to feature him as our soloist in this piece. Please welcome Cantor Russ. Chamber Choir is of Calgary, and they are the pride of Calgary. I would say they have twice won the Healy Willing Prize for best performance in Canada's national competition for amateur choirs. They have put out several recordings. They perform often their own concerts, but then get involved in collaborations on special evenings such as this. Would you please welcome Spiritus Chamber Choir and their director, Dr. Timothy.
I need to say a big thank you as well. Thank you to Jane Perry, the Calgary Renaissance Singers and Players, for really spearheading this, and with cantor Russell Jane too. It's a thrill for us to be here. And this piece we actually performed, the Spiritus Chamber Choir performed, I'd say 7 years ago. And I was first introduced to it 20 years ago when I was singing in the National Youth Choir of Canada with Don Coulter. We performed it in Nova Scotia, and with piano. Actually, it was first written for orchestra and choir, and it's recorded by the Elmer Eisner Singers of Toronto with orchestra. But the piano version is, after we hear the harp, really seems lacking. We are thrilled to have Scott, who has taken on this incredible work with harp, and it's just brought the whole piece to life. So we're thrilled to present this piece. It's in four movements, and we trust that you will enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Choral takes the stage for their first of two sets. There will be a brief intermission. I think you should know that this is the first time that the Los Angeles Cibrial Choral has performed in Canada. Also, a slight housekeeping note that I forgot to mention before. As you may be painfully aware, we ran out of programs, which is a good thing to have happen, I think. So if you don't need a program or you really want to get to know your neighbor very well, please feel free to share the programs. And we do apologize, but we ran out. So please share programs with those who need if you can. Thank you.
Don't forgive me, I'm for some reason a little hoarse. I'm not not accustomed to the clean air. We're going to start the program with two pieces by Aminadav Aloni, who is an Israeli composer who spent most of his career in Los Angeles as a film composer and the music director at Valley Gashalom Synagogue. The first is the setting of the 150th Psalm, and the second is a movement from his cantata Kohelet.
Thank you. The race is not to the swift. But then I saw that the battle is not to the brave. The brave is not to the wise. The wealth is not to the clever. And the favor, and the accidents will happen
piece at his 90th birthday program earlier this spring. He was in LA for it. He had written it for us a year ago for a very special bar mitzvah that I'll tell you about in a little while. So we got to premiere the work a year ago and then do it in his presence earlier this year, an invitation and a blessing. It will be conducted by one of our assistant conductors, Daniel Newman Lesson. little rain must fall. So now you have to listen to some music that I wrote. The first piece, Leshami Konata Elohai, was commissioned by Adat Ariel Synagogue in Los Angeles for the installation of their new cantor, Judy Newman Aronoff, who is one of the original members of this choir. And she'll be the soloist. And the next one is over the years I've been asked to write music for a number of weddings. That stopped when people began to realize that each one of those marriages ended in divorce. And this one, I rewrote for the previous cantor at Adat Ariel, who was had a great bass voice. And the soloist will be Jim Raycroft, who is originally from Edmonton. And I understand his family, a lot of his family is here tonight, and I hope you enjoy, you all enjoy hearing him sing as well.
My soul, my life, and pure and fine. Can you move forward a bit? Forward. Yeah, great. And to your left a little. To your left a little.
Song that we did earlier in the second part of the concert.
this was a piece that was written for, what was the movie, Damsels? No, what? Damsels in Distress. And Fred Astaire sang it in the film, but this is the original version, I think. And with a soprano and a bass, it's called The Jolly Tar and the Milkmaid.
It's all right.
There was a jolly toaster star who met a milkmaid bonny. He said, "How beautiful you are with a hay and a nonny." Such golden hair I ne'er did see, with lips to shame the cherry. Oh, buxom milkmaid, marry me with a down a derry.
With a down a derry.
Our hearts could rhyme, said she, 'tis mountain I'm, said she. But I mean, you see, I happen to be the mother of three. A wife already, a mother of three. A three.
The jolly tar, he laughed aloud, "Is for the best, my bonny, that you won't be my better half with a hay and a nonny.
With a hay and a nonny.
I cast for him in seeing you, that I've a wife in Kerry, in Spain, and also Timbuktu, with a down a derry.
With a down a derry.
You've got me thinking twice, goodbye to shoes and rice, for oh, I'm here now, you see, just now, you see, I happen to be the husband of three. A sliced already, and husband of three, of three,
of three, of three,
of three. Of three.